Hey, how's it going, guys? Mr. Boss for the win here, and in today's Red Dead Redemption 2 video, we're going to be figuring out what exactly happens if your character gets thrown in jail in Red Dead Online. So this is something that Rockstar sort of teased on their newswire when they started talking about the new Frontier Pursuits update, specifically with the Bounty Hunter role. And we first got sort of word that something like this might happen when they said that players who become a level 12 and higher Bounty Hunter will have the opportunity to turn in other players with bounties of 20 or more. And they said bounty hunters will be notified through an invite about the opportunity to hunt down the wanted player or when they're nearby in a structured pursuit. And if the person they're catching up with surrenders, they have the opportunity to bring them in jail. They'll receive an award while the criminal serves time. So there was a lot of unknowns about that, like how is it going to work? How long does your character stay in jail for? Is it like 4 hours? Would, you know, players be stuck there and they'd like have to go play another game where they literally couldn't escape? We're going to be answering all those questions in today's video. So let's begin as the person getting thrown in jail first. I feel like that's actually the more interesting thing here. And in order for something like this to occur, you actually need to get a $10 bounty or higher. Now, there's a couple of levels of what amount of bounty you need to reach. I'll actually explain that in a little bit. Now, if you want to try something like this for yourself, my recommendation is to go to a big city like Saint Denis or Blackwater and just start shooting people. Now, be prepared. You are going to lose a ton of honor points here. So obtaining a really high bounty like this, number one, you have to go out of your way in order to get this. So it's going to be kind of rare if you see someone. Again, we'll talk about that in a little bit. But as soon as you get a $10 bounty, you will get an in-game notification or like an alert that says your bounty value is now high enough to attract bounty hunters. And if you reach a bounty level of 20 or higher, you will get this in-game notification that says your bounty value is increasing and bounty hunters will be more persistent in pursuing you. So those are the two levels right there. Once you reach a $10 bounty or higher, NPC bounty hunters will be able to come after you. Once you reach a level 20 bounty or higher, that is when players who are bounty hunter rank 12 can actually come after you. So there is a little bit of a difference here. And when you get to that $10 amount, NPC bounty hunters can turn you in. And let's actually take a look at what that looks like right now. So as you guys can see here, I've amassed like an $18 bounty, something like that. So not, you know, 20 where other players can come after me, but NPCs can certainly come after me. And what happened was after a while, I got this alert on screen that said hunted, wanted dead or alive for $18.25, the reward for capturing my bounty. And the people coming after me right now were NPC bounty hunters. You can see when I aim in on them, they're just called bounty hunter. And you can do a handful of things here. You can use emotes, which I think is funny. You can surrender or you can aim your weapon. Now, a couple of things can happen here. If you kill the bounty hunters and escape, you can avoid paying off the full bounty value, which is nice. But again, it's not that big of a deal. Or you could surrender. And if you surrender, it'll say hunt over, $18.25 collected. So your bounty will be wiped and you will be taken to jail. Now, you guys can see here that there's a couple of things going on. So I'm going to slow it down just a little bit. In the top left-hand corner, it says bribe your way out of jail early or serve your time. Your bribe is based on the time remaining on your sentence. So my bribe started at $9.12 and would go down like every second, like 50 cents or so would come off. Now, I had a couple of different actions here. I could look around by hitting triangle. I could hit the bed by hitting square, and I could scratch by hitting circle. Now, what I thought was kind of funny is, and I think this is a glitch, for whatever reason, our character has their gun in jail. Like, I feel like that's lawman or sheriff 101. Don't let the criminal take their gun into the jail cell. So I'm pretty sure that is a glitch. And you can eventually see that my bribe starts to whittle all the way down. And I had another in-game alert that said your bribe to leave jail is lower because you were brought in. So I guess if you surrender to the bounty hunters, it will take less time for you to escape. And then eventually what happens is you are let out of jail. And for me, I ended up getting an award buckle for this, wound up in jail. And then another alert that said, bounty hunters have collected the bounty from you. Avoid being targeted again by keeping your bounty value low. Now, that is just one example of what actually happens if you are thrown in jail. Every time you're thrown in jail, it's a little bit different. This footage I'm showing you guys right now comes from my friend Indo J. I'll leave a link to his channel in the description. He does really cool Red Dead Redemption and GTA videos as well. So in this instance, he was actually thrown in the Rhodes jail. And as you guys can see here, every jail cell is a little bit different, like the way the camera and the cutscene looks. But for the most part, it's exactly the same. You have some various actions. His actions here are frustration, SWAT flies, and stretch. So depending on where you're thrown in jail, it will be a little bit different. He also has that weird glitch too, where he's got like the gun in his hand. That just seems very silly. But regardless, that's what happens. And you can see that you spend about like, you know, 10 or 15, 20 seconds in jail. That's like the longest that I've seen so far. So what happens if you get thrown in jail? Really nothing all that serious. Like, you aren't going to be locked in there for like 4 hours. So there's nothing, you know, crazy like that. You basically just get hunted by the bounty hunters and then you get taken into jail. Really, that's not the worst part about having a bounty that high. When your bounty is like $10 and $20, there's a lot of things you don't have access to. Like, for example, you can't do stranger missions. You also can't take bounties from the bounty board if your bounty is too high. So I think it's going to be pretty uncommon that you see a person like this who isn't intentionally trying to get thrown in jail, because there's almost no benefit in Red Dead Online to having a super high bounty. It really just takes away a lot of the features of the game. Now, if you are on the flip side of that, and you are the bounty hunter, what happens if you find someone with a bounty that you can take in? Well, there's going to be a little alert that pops up on your screen. And basically, it's like an invite to a free roam event. And what you have to do is accept it. And when that happens, you will be alerted that you are hunting someone. And the person that you are going for, it'll say on their screen that they are being hunted. And you have 5 minutes to accomplish this. And it's the exact same way that the NPC bounty hunters do it. You basically just have to tie that person up, put them in a bounty wagon, and bring them to jail. It's pretty simple. Now, the difference between the NPC and the other player is the other player has the ability to escape or give up. However, this can be hampered. However, you can hamper their efforts to do that if you have a reinforced lasso, if you have the bolas, if you have one of the bounty hunting wagons. So these are things that will allow you to accomplish this a bit easier, but it's just with another player instead of an NPC. And then when you actually deliver them to the jail, you get a little bit of a cutscene and you actually have to bring them in to the jail cell. And you can actually view them getting like thrown into the jail. And if you do so successfully, you will get paid. Now, you cannot see the person you have thrown in jail in the actual cell. They are taken to like their own little separate cutscene and like their own little separate world. That's why like the screen goes black momentarily, because that person's sort of being transferred out of the world for a second. So you can't actually find them in the jail, which I did find to be kind of disappointing. Now, it's completely different from single player. Like, I'm sure you guys know, if you've ever been thrown in jail as Arthur or John, usually there's like these super intricate cutscenes where one of the other gang members will break them out. Nothing like that happens here in Red Dead Online. It's a little bit more static, where you really just have the ability to wait, do some simple animations, and from there just wait out your sentence until you are free. And like I mentioned earlier, when you do go to jail, your bounty will be paid for, and when you get out, you will have no remaining bounty. Now, if you guys are worried that the bounty hunters sort of have an unfair advantage here because they're going to be told where you are at all times, well, one thing that Rockstar did with this, like they've done with a lot of the things in Red Dead Online, is they've made it proximity-based. So let's say, for example, you're in Saint Denis and someone obtains a level $20 bounty or higher in Blackwater, they're not going to be notified of it. You have to be within like a certain radius. Now, I don't know what that radius is, but you should have a good idea now that you won't be able to see bounties of other players like halfway across the map. That's just not going to happen. So I think that's Rockstar's way of trying to balance this so that bounty hunters aren't just going from like point A to point B, lassoing people up who happen to have a super high bounty again. I don't think people will have that high of a bounty necessarily, but it is good to know that it is proximity based, like pretty much everything else in Red Dead Online also. So quickly recapping here, this is just sort of a fun little feature of the bounty hunting role that Rockstar has introduced in Red Dead Online, although it's nothing really serious. If you are able to find someone with a $20 bounty and take them into jail, good for you. You get a little bit of extra money. It's a fun little objective. If you are taken to jail because you do have a $20 bounty for whatever reason, just know that it's really not that big of a deal. And you're not going to be stuck in jail for like an extended amount of time. It's like, 15 or 20 seconds. So it's something you won't really have to worry about. It'll be a minor inconvenience. But at the end of the day, that's really it. And honestly, who has a $20 bounty? Like, I had to go so out of my way to go on this murdering rampage just to get one. I don't think a lot of players play like that. So I don't think you're going to encounter many that have a $20 bounty that will give you the threshold to ultimately take them in. But maybe I'm wrong. Maybe there's a lot of players out there that love going on killing sprees. And if that's the case, there might be a ton of $20 bounties out there waiting for you to turn in. But anyways, that's all the information that I've got for you guys in this video today. Hopefully you did enjoy. I'd love to hear from you guys in the comments down below. Have you turned any bounties? Have you been turned into jail? Let me know your thoughts down there. If you guys did go on to enjoy this video though, a like rating would of course be awesome. And remember to subscribe if you are new, you want to stay up to date on all the latest Red Dead Redemption 2 and GTA videos that I'm doing here on my channel. And be sure to ring that notification bell as well. Sometimes YouTube just doesn't work, and if you ring that bell, you'll always be guaranteed to be notified when new videos arrive. But of course, as always, guys, thank you all so much for watching. Take care, and I'll see you guys in the next video.